good evening from a happy Xfinity Center, where Maryland takes it over the Minnesota Golden Gophers 77-66. I'm Wayne Viner, Bruce Posner, Robert Stevens. Bruce, what'd you make of tonight's game?
Well, I think it was a bounce off of the game Monday night. I thought they played great Monday night, minus the last play of the game. But I thought Terps did a great job, and it continued tonight. I'm not happy about some of the guys not getting offensively into the game that could prove troublesome with, like, some of the tough games coming up.
Right.
You're not going to beat a Michigan State or Indiana on the road with Wiley and Nickens not scoring.
What did you think of Anthony Cowan?
Cowan was super. We'll give that to Robert.
15 points in the second half. I thought Anthony was outstanding.
Double-double.
And double-double, 10 assists. And that was something that Maryland had not been doing in the second half. They had stepping up. So I thought he played a great ball game.
Yep.
Wayne, well, your comments on the fact that Maryland, even though they scored 77, Maryland's slowing that ball down a little bit, and I think it's working.
Oh, absolutely. For a little while in the second half, first of all, Maryland scores 29 points in the first half, and you know, they have a lead, a one-point lead. They get down immediately in the second half, and they take a lead back, and they really don't give it up. They were 9 of 11, maybe 10 of 11 at one point with 10 assists. The pace worked, and I'll tell you that when players tried to speed it up, it happened to Wiley, it happened to Tomajic. Mark pulled him right out because they weren't playing the right pace.
Robert, it seems like the only guy who's going really strong to the hoop, besides Checo, who had a nice game, is Darryl Morsell, a freshman, which is hard to imagine. But when they're in trouble, he has no qualms about taking it strong. Always not successful.
It looks like Nickens has lost a lot of confidence
Nickens
in this game
has.
Right there. Yeah, but I thought they did a great job of getting Chakowski the ball. Right. Where we discussed, he didn't have to dribble and put the ball on the floor.
No, and even
catch the ball over the rim
and dunk.
Put it in the basket for the dunk.
There were a couple of times, I think Cowan and Herter, the lob pass was so good it might have gone in without Checo's help. So that's good passing there.
You know what? He would do better if there was no backboard. Because when he tries to use the backboard, it almost never works.
That's true.
You know, and he sometimes, instead of stuffing the ball, he tries to finesse the backboard, and it's just not there.
And get it back to Anthony Cowan. The first half, he had, what, 6 assists?
He still played well.
You were talking about, he played well. He distributed the basketball.
Right.
Then in the second half, he came alive, and he kept Maryland. Maryland really needed this ball game.
Oh, my goodness,
For NCAA consideration.
Yep. And you can't leave Herter out of the conversation, who as soon as Minnesota decided to play zone, they just get it to Herter, he makes the three, and that's the end of the zone.
Yeah, and Cowan hit a couple bombs from
right there
in the corner, and wide open, good pass from Herter. And
it's a good offensive night, and as good an offensive night, Maryland's interior defense had enough blocks, enough rebounds. They out-rebound Minnesota. It was a good enough night. 77-66. Maryland, we will be back with the scoreboard and some more analysis here on the Viner Four Gates postgame show. We'll be back after this break.
Meyer Consulting Engineers. In the past 5 years, our organization has completed over 1,300 projects in the U.S. and abroad, including many structures at the University of Maryland. For structural engineering and materials testing and inspection, call Meyer Consulting Engineers.
Back here at Xfinity Center, Maryland 77-66 over the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Both of them came in 14-6. Joining us in the second segment, along with Bruce Posner, is Jeff Ermann. Jeff, tell everybody, before I forget to ask you, where they can find you on Twitter and about your publication.
So on Twitter, I'm at Jeff_Ermann, E-R-M-A-N-N, and my site is called InsideMDSports.com.
You have a lot of followers. You've been doing this for a while. How long have you been inside Maryland sports?
I've been doing this for about 12 years. Before that, at newspapers, but digital online, I've covered Maryland for the past 12 years. So it's been a little while.
And we've enjoyed Josh. He's been on a couple of our Tuesdays at Maryland Stadium. Who dressed you? You look perfectly Maryland.
My wife.
Tonight.
Who else? My wife. This is her favorite jacket. Yeah. It always gets compliments.
She didn't know you were going to be on TV, though, right?
No, she didn't. Maybe it's.
What were your impressions?
Maybe she's trying to keep the other women away.
What were your impressions tonight?
No, I think they played great. You know, now I don't want to say great. They, you know, they came out a little slow. They led for the final 29 minutes of the game, so it was really never in doubt. Minnesota's not at full force. You know, they're kind of stumbling toward the middle of the pack lately. But, you know, more than anything, I felt like it was just a chance to rebound from that Michigan loss. There was, you know, this was a possible kind of free fall after a loss like that. So they
rebounded. Well, I think it turned out to be an incentive because they took a team that was much better than them on the road, a team that had just beat Michigan State, and they took them. They had them beat. It's just the unfortunate end of the game. And I think they parlayed off of that. And slowing that ball down has meant a lot.
Yeah.
It's changed the nature of the team.
Well, I think you're starting to see Turgeon coach. He's been left with fewer players than he thought.
He has no choice.
No choice. He has to coach the guys that he has, and suddenly it looks like a better team.
It does, but you've got to be cautious when you say that just because, you know, the competition in the middle of the Big Ten is a little down this year. But, yeah, no, they have played better. Kevin Herter, I thought, was great tonight. You can see him gradually turning into a star. I think next year he's a full-fledged star.
So, the thing we got to remember, I don't want to interrupt you. Maryland has played three of the toughest four games they're going to play all year. The three games on the road, the Michigan, Ohio State, Michigan State, and you have Purdue left.
You got Purdue at Purdue and Michigan State here.
Right.
So those are your hardest games.
And you got Michigan here. But my point is the ones on the road are much more problematical.
Sure.
All right? If you look at the rest of the schedule, you know, Maryland cannot assume anything. But I'll tell you, they'll be favored against Rutgers at home. They'll be favored against who else we got at home? They'll be favored against Michigan at home. Won't be favored against Michigan State. So, in other words, their chances of winning are, and Wisconsin, they're definitely going to be favored. Right.
Tuesday's a sneaky one. Tuesday's a big game at Indiana.
Indiana's
really improved.
It's Monday, I think.
I think it's Tuesday. Okay. Indiana's playing much better defense.
Well, that's one they need to steal.
You know, it's a winnable but a tough game. Indiana's won three or four in a row. They play great defense, so that's one that, you know, you're really going to have to get one of those mid-level Big Ten games that
so
they
need. Today's Thursday. You got Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. They should be ready, and then you got another 5 days off until the Michigan State game,
and then you're at Purdue. So this is going to be a nice stretch here. You need you need to win one of the three.
Oh, clearly one. Two would be a major
victory.
Three is highly unlikely, but two would be
Two would be a major victory.
What do you think of the development of Cowan? What's his ceiling?
Oh, I mean, I think he's getting to be just about as good as Melo Trimble was. You know, you don't see the inconsistency that Trimble had. You don't see those 4-for-18 nights that we saw with Mel. He doesn't have that same kind of high-end scoring ability quite, although he's starting to show that even. You know,
he is.
I think he had 17, 10, and 6 tonight. You know, so that's impressive.
And the 10 assists are the most since Melo had 10 two or three years ago. So that's a good number.
Hell of a floor game. I didn't see for sure, but I think he only had 3 or 4 turnovers.
Right. Yeah. He had 3 turnovers to 10 assists.
That's all. Well, that's a great game. Considering he played virtually 48 minutes. That'd be 40 minutes, I think.
40 minutes.
He's leading leading the Big Ten in minutes played.
Right.
It is what it is.
It is. So before we wrap this up tonight from Xfinity Center, what have you heard about any Walt Bell replacement news?
Everybody seems to be asking me that same question tonight.
Ask them. Does everybody ask
them? Jetfish?
I think that would be huge. I don't see that one happening. I know Durkin loved him the first time around and wanted to hire him. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't have a name for you. I do know that Durkin, from what I'm hearing, has a guy already lined up, and it's not going to be long. So I don't think it's going to be a drawn-out search where you're going from one guy to the next. Right. I think it's going to wrap up soon.
Same style or different style?
I would think the same style. I don't think you can win in Maryland with a smash mouth. You know, you got to take advantage of the athletes here. You're not going to beat Michigan or Wisconsin at their own game. So I would guess same style.
All right. Well, Jeff, I thank you for coming on.
Yeah,
thank
tell
you.
Everybody where they about your site.
InsideMDSports.com. We're part of the 24/7 Sports Network. So if you'd like to follow Terps and Maryland recruiting, check us out.
All right. Thanks for being on.
Thanks for having me.
This has been the Viner Four Gates Post Game Show, Bruce.
Also brought to you by Meyer Consulting.
Consulting
for years and years
of Rockville. And we're going to leave you with the Maryland, you could say, National Championship lacrosse team.
What a great night. I think that pushed the night forward when you had champions on the floor, and they are champions.
And they open against Navy when?
November the 10th. Naturally.
February the 10th.
February 10th. Naturally at the same time as the Maryland-Northwestern game, which only Maryland seems to find to do.
Okay. Well, we're going to leave here happy. 77-66, Terps over Minnesota. We will see you on the radio on Saturday morning on 1300 CBS Sports Radio, and we'll be back here at Xfinity Center for the Michigan State game.
John Tillman will be on my radio show on Saturday morning, the Sports Maven, and we'll have a lot of Stephon Diggs comments as well.
All right.
All right, goodbye, everybody. Jeff, thanks for coming on.
Thank you, guys. All right.
Good evening from Xfinity Center.
Last day, the Maryland men's lacrosse team was etched into history when it captured the 2017 National Championship. With the pressure of 42 long years on their shoulders, head coach John Tillman's pair have been split through the NCAA tournament with a desire that was unmatched. The Terps season begins February 10th and features seven exciting